Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the DiabetesCouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Now, I want to emphasize that my perspective is coming from one with type 2 diabetes and not type 1. Our channel is primarily for those with type 2 diabetes and pre-diabetes. Today, I want to answer the question, are there symptoms of pre-diabetes? After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you'll find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks, and there are also tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. I try to do a lot of research for these videos, and I came across a statistic this week while researching for this particular video that just blew me away. I mean, I really had no idea that this statistic was as bad as it was. A shocking 9 out of 10 people who have prediabetes don't know they have it. I was one of those 9. Why? Well, almost all medical journals I have researched on this topic have concluded that, in general terms, prediabetes has no symptoms. However, Dr. Ashita Gupta says if you have certain signs of type 2 diabetes in a less severe form, you could have a diagnosis before it becomes type 2. So, if you experience any of the following, just one of them, it would be a good idea for you to ask your doctor to check your blood glucose. A blurry vision. Sudden spikes and dips in your blood sugar, which are common in those with prediabetes, can impair your eye's ability to bend and focus, leading to blurred vision, according to Dr. Gupta. The blurriness should go away once you get your sugar levels back into normal range. Excessive thirst. One or more well-known signs of prediabetes and diabetes is excessive thirst, and it occurs in response to the surplus sugar in the blood. Your body attempts to flush the excess into the urine, which means you'll need to go more often than usual. This, in turn, can cause dehydration, making you feel thirsty. Stubborn wounds or infections. High blood sugar can slow your circulation, so skin takes longer to repair itself. As a result, minor bruises and cuts might take longer than usual to heal. The condition can also promote the growth of bacteria and fungi, which may lead to repeat infections, especially of the skin or vagina, like urinary tract infections. Extreme fatigue. Your body uses blood sugar for fuel, but prediabetes causes insulin resistance, which means your body isn't able to effectively convert the glucose in your blood into energy. This leaves you with severe fatigue, and sometimes even flu-like symptoms. Sudden, unexplained weight gain or loss. When the body isn't able to get the energy it needs from blood glucose, it starts burning other things for fuel, resulting in weight loss, even if you're not on a diet or working out. On the other hand, insulin resistance can make you feel hungry, which can cause weight gain. And darkened areas of skin. High insulin levels can speed the rate at which skin cells reproduce, leading to a condition called acanthosis nigricans. It occurs when skin on the back of the neck, under the arm, or in the creases of your elbows begin to darken, maybe even your knuckles, and they take on a smooth or velvety feeling. If you feel you've experienced any of these signs, I suggest you make an appointment with your healthcare provider and tell them you have a concern about diabetes. You should then be given, at the very least, a glucose screening and hopefully even an A1C test. You may not have anything, but what's the harm in a small test to find out? Don't forget to get my new ebook, and please subscribe to our channel for many more videos like this one in the future. I want to thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.